Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is BestInSlot, and tonight we're going to try to answer a question that's plagued Jurassic World Evolution since the game first came out. This is something you guys have been asking me over and over again, and that is, what dinosaurs can actually live together? Which dinosaurs are compatible with which other dinosaur types? Now, I'm going to bring up a little chart that I've made up on the screen right now. You can see this is what I've made, but this is based on one by SmithSP86 over on Reddit. Now, I'm going to link his original thread down below. He's done a lot of great work. He's done this whole Excel sort of thing. I think it's got multiple people working on it, but on that it shows the dinosaur compatibility, but it also shows a bunch of other statistics about the dinosaurs. If you've been wondering how to build the ultimate park and you want to plan it out beforehand, I really recommend you go and give that Excel spreadsheet a look. It's not quite finished yet. There's still some work to be done. This is quite preliminary stuff. Now, before we get started, and I want to explain what's going on here a little bit more, this is quite a hard game to make blanket statements about. There's varying different things that come into play as to whether these dinosaurs can live together. So I've set up four exhibits that I'm going to show you exactly what I mean by that. Let's take a little look, shall we? Let's hop into the map and head over, first of all, to the northwest. This is the armored herbivore and the small carnivore. Now, as far as we can tell, this is the only herbivore-carnivore mix, other than the giant herbivores, that doesn't really have much interaction. Some people have reported... Quiet, Joe. Some people have reported the small carnivores and the medium herbivores, stuff like the ceratopsids, in particular the triceratops, being able to live together in happiness. However, I'm not totally convinced on that. I think a lot of it depends on the size of your exhibit and stuff like that. We'll get into that a little bit more in a minute. But there is a chance that, as well as armored herbivores, medium herbivores, you may also want to have ceratopsids in there. They may be their own group. Like I said, this is a very hard game to make blanket statements about, but it seems the velociraptors are smart enough to not make an attempt to kill the big, thick, happy, chubby Nodosaurus, which seems like the smart thing to me, because I don't think they'd stand much of a chance. So, just to explain quickly why this is important as well, let's say you're trying to build a park with every single dinosaur in it. That is a very difficult thing to do. You have very limited space, particularly on Isla Nublar, and particularly in 2 days' time when the Fallen Kingdom DLC comes out, and we don't have to fit 42 dinosaurs, we have to fit 46. 48 even, I can't even count to 48. Be quiet, Jeep. Anyways, so this is a nice little combination. They won't touch each other, they'll live in relative happiness, there's no panicking or anything. You can see the raptor is sort of getting... Okay, that one's panicking right now. It seems they do panic, but nothing really matters. I'll have to contradict myself pretty much immediately, but I'm going to prove why this is important over here in the top right. So, this is a large carnivore and a small carnivore. Now, it is a Majungasaurus. And you may be thinking, BestInSlot, Majungasaurus isn't a large carnivore. Well, it turns out it is. For the purposes of the game, there are large carnivores and there are small carnivores. There really isn't anything in between. So small carnivores is your Dilophosaurus, your Deinonychus, and your Velociraptor, and all the other carnivores in the game, even the smaller ones like the Majungasaurus, like the Ceratosaurus, which is actually fairly huge, or the even the Suchomimus isn't that big, are all classed as large carnivores. Even though the Metrocamphosaurus would be another good example. Even though this guy is much smaller than a T-Rex or the Indominus Rex, for example, he's still a large carnivore. Large carnivores and small carnivores can live together in absolute harmony. However, you need to make sure you've got multiple food sources and multiple water sources, as you can see I have here. These Deinonychus will panic. You can see one panicking right there. They will panic and they will run away from the larger carnivores. They never fight. It doesn't seem like a big deal, but if you only have one water source and one food source, you may have seen it on my playthrough when we got to Isla Muerta, you'll have this problem wherein your Deinonychus will roam down to the river to try and get a drink, the Majungasaurus will charge in, the Deinonychus will panic, run away, and it won't be able to eat, it won't be able to drink. The Majungasaurus will scare it away from the food source. So if you are going to do something like this, which you will have to do if you want to fit all the dinosaurs in one park, in my opinion, we'll talk about why in a second, you're going to want at least two food sources, like so, and at least a few water sources, just so your dinosaurs can kind of separate out from each other a little bit. Now, the reason this is important is because the large carnivores, as in the Majungasaurus, the Ceratosaurus, the T-Rex, the Suchomimus, Spinosaurus, blah, 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 can't live together at all. They will fight and they will kill. Again, this is something people have kind of have their own opinions about, but assuming your exhibit isn't so big that the dinosaurs never meet, these dinosaurs will fight each other. This isn't necessarily about, can you put these dinosaurs together? It's, can these dinosaurs kill each other? Should you risk putting these dinosaurs together, or would you rather have a nice, safe exhibit? This is important because basically, since all your carnivores have to be separate, that's really inefficient, especially if you want to get every single dinosaur in the game into one park. So instead of having Majungasaurus, Ceratosaurus, blah blah, all separated, now what you can do is Majungasaurus and Deinonychus, Ceratosaurus and Velociraptor, Metriacanthosaurus and Deinonychus, and that way you've doubled up the number of carnivores in your exhibits, you've saved a lot of space, and since the small carnivores can't live together either, you know, Dilophosaurus and Velociraptor will fight, you see that on Werter all the time. It's really important to double up like that if you're trying to be efficient. And as long as you've got multiple food sources, they should be okay. These Deinonychus and this Majunga have been living together for a good half an hour or so now. You can see their comfort is all 100%. Everyone's having a good old time. Aren't you, babes? Yeah, cool. Right, moving up to the northeast now for the first look at the giant herbivores. This is a Camarasaurus. We've got two of these in this big old exhibit, mainly because the Camarasaurus is a pain in the ass and requires a lot of forest. But we also have a large carnivore. I'm just going to get rid of the forest around there so we can see it. This is the Giganotosaurus. Now, the Giganotosaurus and other large carnivores will kill everything in the game other than small carnivores and giant herbivores. So your Deinonychus, blah, 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 and then your sauropods are all pretty much safe. They will kill the armored herbivores, they will kill the medium herbivores. These, again, have been living together in absolute perfect harmony for about half an hour or so. And this doesn't seem like a big deal, but if you're trying to get every dinosaur into your park, the problem with the sauropods and stuff is they take up a lot of room, and they don't necessarily make the best use of it. You could just cram loads of herbivores in here, but because they're very forest heavy, you don't get much grassland. The carnivores, generally speaking, tend to be less picky on that. You can see here, the grassland and forest is absolutely full for this little guy. Sometimes, if you're going to have a sauropod exhibit, it's worth just chucking a carnivore in there, see what happens, basically. They should get along absolutely fine. We're about efficiency here, folks. We're all about efficiency. Some of you are going to disagree with what I've said today and my little chart in the video, in the comments down below. I'm sure you will, because people have got evidence of certain dinosaurs living together. Somebody posted about a T-Rex and Indominus Rex and Velociraptors all living together in harmony. I suspect a lot of that is to do with comfort levels, lack of storms, size of exhibits, stuff like that. This is the way to do it if you want to keep your dinosaurs safe. It is, however, like I say, kind of still in progress. Look at that, they're best friends. It is kind of still in progress. The game is actually quite complex in its dinosaur-to-dinosaur interactions, even if the basic AI is very simple. So it's going to take a little bit more time for us to get the full list of interactions sort of down. I'm just trying to give you a quick and dirty guide, basically. Now, I already recorded this northwest bit in a video a little earlier on, so I'm going to cut over to that now. Enjoy! There is nothing in this game the Indominus Rex can live with safely. Absolutely nothing. Now, people have again posted about this, their own experiences of an Indominus Rex living with Tyrannosaurus Rex and some raptors. I saw that on the Discord, stuff like that. If your exhibit is huge enough that these dinosaurs never come into contact with each other, then there are ways for that to work. There are ways for dinosaurs that shouldn't live together to be able to live together. But the point is, do these dinosaurs have a built-in kill animation? Do they actually hunt each other? And the fact is, Indominus Rex will kill anything in the game if it gets the chance. For good reason, you know, that's what the Indominus Rex should do. But we are going to release a Mementosaurus and an Indominus Rex. I've never seen this. I've never seen an Indominus Rex take down a giant herbivore. I know it can be done, but I'm quite excited to see it happen for... In reality, I'm very excited, and this is my final test. This is one that shouldn't work. Which makes Indominus Rex very annoying. Indominus Rex requires a lot of space. You know, look at that neck. Oof. Absolutely snapped in half. Beautiful, though. That's a long neck boy right there. Okay, enough of that. I'm just going to do one thing very quickly. I'm going to kill my carnivore feeders for this exhibit. I just want to make sure the Indominus Rex does not have an alternate feeding source. And we're going to also bring in the herbivore feeder down to this side. Okay, let's release the Indominus. My favorite pattern for the Indominus, this one. Rainforest skin pattern. Ooh, love it. It's the only one with that little bit of color on it. There is a brown one, but it's not quite the same. My monsters are so dirty. Give that a little clean. Here we go. Absolutely goddamn terrifying. Okay, so in theory, this one shouldn't work. The Indominus should be capable of taking down the Mementosaurus. Let's see if that is how it happens in reality. But generally speaking, it was obvious, don't put your Indominus Rex with other dinosaurs. It's an absolute goddamn monster. Momenshi's probably going to be quite unhappy, isn't it? Yeah, it needs a lot more forest, but I kind of just want to see it die. I know it sounds mean, but I also don't care, so... We're not here to make the dinosaurs happy. You, go kill. Kill, crush, destroy. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. I've got to say, that took a bloody long time. That took a solid... I've been here for 15 minutes or so waiting for that to actually happen. I was a little worried that I'd made a mistake. I started to lower the comfort of both dinosaurs, so my Menchie's been upset for a long time. Now, the Indominus has just hit red comfort, but during the kill, it still had food, it still had blue comfort as well. So it doesn't seem to be related. It simply seemed to be, from my perspective, that... The Indominus just kind of randomly decides to do it at some point. It may be just when its food gets low. It's quite hard to say. The food was... It wasn't in the red, but it was getting closer. So it's very hard to say whether the two are connected or whether there is a random happenstance. It's a very cool little animation. I can see how the Indominus would take down such a big-ass dinosaur. But this is kind of just proving the point that it's very hard to... Like, people have been asking me to make this video, but it's very hard to just blanket say... what will happen with your dinosaurs. These three here are safe bets. Whether this is the most efficient thing to do is a whole other matter. The ankylosaurids in particular have very, very strict population limits. It's very hard to get them all living together. What it might be worth doing is taking a look at that really cool spreadsheet that I'm going to link down below. Look at, say, all the ankylosaurids, how many you need of each, and see if they would all go into one exhibit. You might need two or three to actually make it work. I think if you were going to plan the ultimate park, what you'd have to do is plan out each exhibit beforehand based on the minimum social need of each dinosaur and what they can live with. So you would probably put medium carnivores with... large carnivores with the Deinonychus, because you can't put large carnivores together. So if you want a Majungasaurus and a Ceratosaurus, you'll see here, they're not fighting, they're kind of... Deinonychus is being silly. You're not gonna win this, buddy. And at some point it gets scared away and kind of gives up. As you can see. My point is, you can't put a Ceratosaurus, a Majungasaurus, a T-Rex, a Suchomimus. You can't put these dinosaurs together. What you could do is build an exhibit with a Majungasaurus and a Dilophosaurus, a T-Rex, a Velociraptor, a Suchomimus, a Deinonychus, and that way you're doubling up, you're fitting more species in. It's going to be very difficult due to the unfortunately limited size of Isla Nublar to make a park with every single dinosaur. People have done it, and it's going to get even harder on Friday, tomorrow, when those extra six dinosaurs come in. Day after tomorrow. What day? Is it Wednesday? I'm going to say it's Wednesday. I hope you guys see what I mean. Hopefully this did help a little bit. You should know some basics now about how you can put your exhibits together. Really, the only thing you need to worry about is the Indominus Rex. That's the only thing that will live with absolutely nothing else. Every other type of dinosaur can double up in some way. I'm going to link that thread down below. I'll also link my own image if you want to use it as a quick referral guide. Bear in mind, it isn't absolutely exact. If anything is different with it, I think it may be the ceratopsids. We'll have to wait and see. But bear in mind, other things like food sources, size of exhibits, stuff like that will all come into play when determining whether your dinosaurs can live together or not. But a little bit of research, a little bit of work on your own, and you should be able to make a pretty damn cool dinosaur park. Anyways, we're going to end it there. Finally, I don't have to sit here for 20 bloody minutes waiting for a mudder. Cheers, much love. If this video helped you out, please do hit the like button. Bye-bye. Quick little shout out at the end. This video and others like it would not be possible at all without the support of you guys watching me at home, and also everyone on this Patreon page right here who supported me in the last month. If you want to help out as well, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. Every little really helps. Cheers.